Hey guys, how's it going? This is David Kwan. So EA is the most hated company, the most awful company in America, according to that poll that was done, according to that user vote thing that was done. People hate EA currently, and there's some people who are just like, I'm never going to buy any EA game ever again, which surprises me. I don't know where the hate comes from. I mean, apparently, of course, it does come from their DRM policies, especially with their failures with SimCity and what have you. I guess it's understandable, but the games that they released have always been pretty good quality. I mean, even the games that have massive amount of problems with it, like Mass Effect 3, for example, was a huge controversial game, but I actually really, really enjoyed that game. That's one of my favorite games I played last year. Yeah, the whole year, that was actually like, if it wasn't for the ending, I wouldn't be surprised if it was a game of the year. That game was amazing. And that was an EA game from BioWare. There's so many games that EA puts out, even on the iPhone. I'm still playing Real Racing 3, that's an EA game. Maybe they're the publishers, so it's probably the credit probably goes to the developers behind this game. But Real Racing 3 on the iPhone 4, or any other iPhone, like iPhone 5 or iPhone 4S would probably be a better platform to play. Amazing stuff. But anyway, let's talk about E3. E3 2013. I'm going to argue, and you guys will probably disagree with me, or you might agree with me, that EA had the strongest lineup in E3 as a publisher. I kind of hate talking about publisher's lineup because it does leave out independent developers, because they usually have one game to showcase. So it kind of just leaves them out in the dust, and they don't get compared. You know, in this discussion, Witness is not going to be discussed. Octodad is not going to be discussed. Transistor is not going to be discussed. Because they have one game, and they're independent developers. And it's only the big publishers that have these humongous lineup of games. I think EA has not only the largest lineup of games, it also has the strongest lineup of games. So let's bring up other publishers. You know, we have Sony. Sony has their PS3 titles, you know, Gran Turismo 6, Last of Us, Beyond Two Souls, The Order 1886, which is now moving on to PS4 territory, Drive Club, Killzone Shadowfall, Infamous Second Son, and Tearaway, which is a PSP title. So there's, you know, Sony has a good lineup too. But like, out of all those titles, not many people are too excited. The Order 1886, the only thing we can rely on is the pedigree of Sony Santa Monica. We know that Sony Santa Monica is an amazing developer with their track record of God of War games, so that's why we are excited. And they had an in-game trailer, a CGI trailer that looked fantastic, but we still don't know what the game is about, what the gameplay is going to be like. So there's still kind of like too much up in the air that we don't know about to be that excited for The Order of 1886. I think most people, the most excitement that a Sony game is getting right now is Infamous Second Son. I think that game has got the most attention, other than, of course, The Last of Us, which just came out. So, that's Sony. Microsoft has got a lot of games, but there's not many games that are, like, super, super grabbing to you. They got, what, Rise? No, thank you. Rise is no thank you. Forza Motorsport 5 looks pretty awesome, but it's, you know, they kind of announced Halo, kind of, not really, just kind of teased Halo. Quantum Break, again, no thank you. So Microsoft, to me, they got a lineup, but it's not Microsoft themselves, not that strong. Microsoft is really relying on third-party exclusives, which they're pretty good at getting. I'm always surprised that they're able to do it, but they have money, so they can just kind of throw money, develop a relationship. And also, Xbox One, we may not like it as consumers, but it's actually really, really friendly to publishers. So perhaps some publishers really like the idea of developing exclusively on Xbox One, and that might actually make sense. Konami was actually a really weak presence this year. The games they have, Pro Evolution Soccer, Castlevania Lord of Shadows 2, and Metal Gear Solid 5. Now, Metal Gear Solid 5 is like my most favorite game out of the entire event, but that's just because I love Metal Gear Solid. Other than that, I think Konami can be kind of considered eh. Square Enix was pretty surprising. They had, Kingdom Hearts 3 announcement and Final Fantasy 15. And I don't know if any other idol studio is doing anything. The idols just recently released their big games. You know, Hitman Absolution came out, Tomb Raider came out. They're going to do something with Deus Ex, but not sure yet. Oh, yeah, they're doing the mobile game on the iOS platform. Deus Ex, what was the name? Fallen something or Break? I forgot the name of the tablet title. But they're doing that, which, okay, honestly, okay. Anyway, EA is the strongest because look at this lineup. Star Wars Battlefront, which is like, is it a reboot? Does it have a number? I don't know. The Star Wars Battlefront, everyone's excited. That's even though it's just a teaser. Just the fact that EA is going to do that, pretty awesome. Plants vs. Zombies, Garden Warfare. It totally changes the concept of Plants vs. Zombies. It's exclusive to 360, Xbox One, and PC. Looks awesome. I loved Plants vs. Zombies, the original game. I would be honest to say I'm actually much more excited for Plants vs. Zombies 2, It's About Time, which is going to be on the iOS, on my iPhone. Awesome. I'm excited for the sequel. But this Garden Warfare game really kind of twists the concept so that it becomes a third-person shooter tower defense type of game. Looks exciting. Definitely a game to have. Titanfall is going to be huge. That game is going to be huge. I can already see that happening. What else? Man, the Battlefield 4. Seeing that game demoed on the conference just blew me away. And I'm not a big first-person shooter guy, but I know Battlefield 4, that demo was totally scripted. But it was a representation of what the experience would be like on the console, on Xbox One, on PS4, having an online match of 64 players with completely destructible environments, an entire skyscraper crumbles down, like, and all these vehicles, I mean, and the graphics is just, one of these mini journalists were like, that kind of did previews or impressions on that game were just like, this is what Battlefield 3 should have been. That's just what they're saying. And this is an EA game. And Battlefield 4 is going to be huge. So they got Battlefield 4 and they got Titanfall. This is going to be like mass market appeal game. These games are going to be huge. So already with just those two games, EA has an amazing lineup that was really impressive. Those two games, I think, when I think of next gen, I think that's kind of the indication there. Like, these are next gen games that I'm starting to see. Titanfall, Battlefield 4, whew. Garden Warfare looks fun. They also got Need for Speed Rivals. EA's got games. That's really all I gotta say. They got a really strong lineup. And if Titanfall was an Xbox One exclusive, I feel like if they did that, Titanfall would have been Xbox One's savior. You know, even with all these all this consumer negative reaction that it's getting. If Titanfall was Xbox One exclusive, and it turned out to be an amazing game, that game could have been the Halo for Xbox One. But of course, it's also available for Xbox 360. But I feel like on the Xbox 360, Titanfall is going to be downgraded to a huge degree. So I don't know. It could still be a big thing. Titanfall is definitely going to be exclusive for Xbox One. For how long? I don't know. I feel like it's going to be a timed exclusive. I don't think it's going to be an Xbox One exclusive forever, because most of Microsoft's third-party exclusives usually end up on the Sony side, just as how, you know, if you look at the history of 360 and PS3. But I don't know. With Xbox One, the picture might be different, because Xbox One is much friendlier to the publishers than the PS4 is, because PS4 is pretty much the same as PS3. It doesn't change the landscape, the gaming landscape. The Xbox One does change the gaming landscape in favor of publishers. So some publishers may actually opt to do exclusives on the Xbox One and keep it exclusive. I kind of doubt it, but it could happen. Anyway, Titanfall is huge. In my opinion, that game is going to be huge. And EA has all these games. Also, I forgot to mention the EA Sports games. EA's got Madden, EA's got the NBA games, the the hockey games, which was really showcased on FIFA. FIFA is big worldwide. If I was a sports guy, I would really be into EA, but that's the EA lineup. I don't think anyone in this E3 event could compete against that. I think EA, their lineup of games, was the strongest lineup out of all the publishers that showcased their games on E3 2013. That's my opinion. Do you guys disagree, agree? What do you guys think? How excited are you about EA's games, or which publisher appealed to you the most, and which publisher do you think had the best lineup at E3? So, thanks for watching, guys, and cheers.